the recognized worldwide leader in sports.
Director of the Viking Hall Civic Center in Bristol, Tennessee. We're proud to welcome the World Wrestling Federation and their fans to our great city.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Wrestling Challenge. I'm Gorilla Monsoon, joined here by my colleague, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and you can feel the excitement in the air as we are only 1 week away from WrestleMania 4. So batten down the hatches. We've got action coming at you right now. Crowd on hand as usual for Wrestling Challenge this week, because what a tremendous lineup we've got. We're going to be taking a look at the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and you can bet the beautiful Elizabeth will be there as well. And also this special live interview with the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, and the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant,
who I consider the world's heavyweight champion.
Also joining us here this week, Jake the Snake Roberts, and Damien, of course, will be in that ominous little green bag.
Now let me handle this.
Go ahead.
My team, the Islanders, who are also undefeated.
Oh, please. Also, a special WrestleMania 4 report. Let's go to the ring.
Scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring from South Bend, Indiana, weighing 240 pounds, Brian Costello.
Circuit locations. And in fact, as a public service, the World Wrestling Federation this Friday will be listing in the USA Today newspaper all the closed circuit locations for WrestleMania 4 throughout the entire country.
So this Friday, I'll be able to look in the paper, USA Today.
That's correct.
And find out exactly where the closed circuit will be.
That is correct.
Well, then I'll get my tickets in.
Well, we're going to be joined very shortly here by Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, who could meet in WrestleMania 4 the Macho Man.
Oh, Randy Savage, I remember WrestleMania number 3, but this is WrestleMania number 4 coming up. You and I, one more time, if you win your round and I win mine, and this is for the World Wrestling Federation gold. We're going all the way. One more classic confrontation.
Well, if both of them get by those rounds, Brain, they could indeed. You remember WrestleMania 3, what a hot match that was.
There are experts that I've known my whole career that have said they have never seen a better match than last year's WrestleMania 3 Savage Steamboat match.
Right now, the Macho Man doing one heck of a job on Brian Costello as he's perched high up there on the top turnbuckle. Oh, that patented flying elbow. Forget about it. It's over. How impressive is that? Look at the determination on that kisser.
good move. That's a real vicious move by a macho man. I like the standing on the guy chest, the count, the one, two, three. But when it comes, opening the ropes up for your help.
There it is, right here, the Macho Man opening up the ropes for his manager, the lovely Elizabeth. Wow. Showing her the proper respect that she so rightly deserves. Right now, a special report on the WrestleMania Invitational Battle Royal.
All right, we are rapidly moving down the road to Atlantic City. WrestleMania 4, only 1 week away. Hello again, everyone. Next Sunday afternoon at Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino, it is the event of the year, WrestleMania 4. Now, there's no home television for this extravaganza, and all the Trump Plaza tickets are gone now. But you can see WrestleMania 4 at closed-circuit locations near you on giant screens. And how gigantic are they? Well, a bead of sweat is going to appear as large as Andre the Giant's hand. I think that about captures it. Also, WrestleMania 4 available on a pay-per-view basis. Now, kicking off this spectacular, a 20-man Invitational Battle Royal. Participating superstars include Ken Patera, The Killer Bees, Outlaw Ron Bass, Young Sam Houston, and the Junkyard Dog. And we asked JYD about the Battle Royal.
WrestleMania 4, one of the greatest things to ever happen in this world since my mama gave birth to me. And I tell you what, only the strong will survive in WrestleMania 4.
All right, Junkyard Dog gearing up for the Battle Royal. Also involved, the Rougeau Brothers, the Hart Foundation, Bad News Brown, Hillbilly Jim in the Battle Royal, so is King Harley Race. And we asked Mr. Race about the Battle Royal.
19 men are gonna bow. 19 men are gonna beg. And then the king is going to win the Battle Royal.
And also in this 20-man Invitational Battle Royal, Sika is there. The Young Stallions, Dangerous Danny Davis, George the Animal Steel, and the Bolsheviks. And we asked Nikolai Volkov and Boris Zhukov about the Battle Royal.
Oh, yeah, well, you know, just like I tell you, you know, the Russians excelled in the Olympics. These two Russians are going to excel in WrestleMania. Look out, the Bolsheviks, number one.
Okay, the Invitational Battle Royal kicking off the action at WrestleMania 4 next weekend.
Well, Brain, you're 1 week away from putting on the tights. It could be disastrous for you right now. Let's go to Coco Beware and the British Bulldogs.
Oh, yeah! You see, Bobby Heenan, you stole my bird, brother. But I got the bird back. You see, Frankie's on my side. And you know what? Matilda is going to be on the Bulldog side. Isn't that right, Bulldog?
That's right. Oh, and it's Matilda's first appearance back at WrestleMania 4 after Bobby Heenan dognapped her.
That's right. Weasel, Islanders, you're all going to pay WrestleMania 4.
I feel good! It's WrestleMania time, brother! What a time we're gonna have, brother! We're gonna walk and we talk. How can we lose with the stuff we're gonna use? Isn't that right, guys?
Oh, well, I'm sure that you won't be too happy, Brain. 1 week away, you'll have to get terminated out there.
Are you kidding? Now, that dog, I'm not even going through with you.
Here comes the Islanders. Obviously, you did not see fit to go down there and bring your men in.
From the South Pacific,
you're going to desert him like this at WrestleMania 4 a week away?
Haku and the Tama.
Well, speak. Move your lips.
I'll explain to you. I'm staying right here with you. I'll tell you why in a minute.
All right.
From Tucson, Arizona, Dave Stoudemeire. His tag team partner from Griffin, Georgia.
Couple of youngsters trying to make a name for themselves here in the World Wrestling Federation certainly picked a hard way to do it.
Well, that's the only way you're going to get better, but they're not going to get by the Islanders. But the reason I'm staying here with you is I just want to make sure what you and the director do on this television.
Oh, come on.
You don't do anything behind my back. I want to know exactly what the Bulldogs say, what Coco Beware says, because I'm not going to let anybody make a fool out of my Islanders or myself. I'm staying put right here.
Well, they said they were going to do it once and for all, Brain. Make you pay for all the things you've done. Not only to the British Bulldogs and to Coco Beware and to Frankie and to Matilda.
Well, let me tell you something. They should be lucky they got that dog back.
Well, I can feel the... Oh, look at that move. Wise off the turnbuckle. Beautiful maneuver. Surprising Tama. Come on. Another high crossbody referee right there, but only a one count.
This young kid's surprising him, I think.
You know, Brain, the electricity building now that we're only 1 week away? Are you...
Feel it. I got goosebumps all over my body.
Yeah, are you in any kind of shape at all to enter the ring?
Are you kidding? I'm in the greatest shape of my life. I've been working out with the Islanders. I've been over in Atlantic City. I've been running. I've been training with Hercules, the whole family. Are you kidding me?
Well, I want you to take a look at this, if you would, Brain. This is the latest edition of World Wrestling Federation magazine, and the title of this particular article is Heenan, Dogged by Fear.
Oh, I didn't write that article. I'm not dogged by fear, anybody's fear.
Look at the look on your kisser there.
I'm talking to the dog. I'm not going to let any dog intimidate me.
Will you stop?
What's all this talk about a dog? I'm wrestling human beings, not a dog, not a bird.
Well, you're going to have to deal with Matilda. You're going to have to deal with Frankie.
Why? Why do I have to deal with Matilda?
Why?
Yeah, that's a dog. I'm not a dog. I'm a man. Well, I'm an athlete.
Some of the things you do simply doesn't give me that connotation. I am so excited, Brain, about WrestleMania 4. You can't believe it. This is the first time in the history of professional wrestling that you will, in fact, see crowned an undisputed World Wrestling Federation champion. First time in the history, and it's up for grabs.
Never before.
No, never.
And I'm going to be there to strap that gold around the waist of my man, Ravishing Rick Rude.
You're not going to have that honor to do that. That honor's reserved from the gentleman from the Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous, Robert Leach.
I'm going to send him to my house early. So we can get the scoop.
This one is over. The two youngsters didn't fare too well. The experience of the Islanders, too much for them.
The winners of this bout, the Islanders.
Islanders, very impressive. Here it comes. Oh, look at the height on that. At least 11 to 12 feet high in the air. Tama just unloaded on him. Right now, some special interviews with Brutus, the Barber, Beefcake, and of course, the Honky Tonk Man as well.
All right, we're 1 week away from WrestleMania 4 from Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino in Atlantic City. All the tickets are gone in Atlantic City. However, you can join us at a closed-circuit location near you or on a pay-per-view basis. Gladys Knight of the Pips, America the Beautiful, are going to be kicking it all off. Come on in, Brutus the Barber, Beefcake, Honky Tonk Man, and a shot at becoming the Intercontinental Champion of the world.
They're like a disease, Gene. They spread all over the W... As the Barber of the... I'm gonna be the man. I'm gonna cut them guys right out of the picture. The belt's coming home to me, and it's all over but the crying. Boo hoo.
All right, I get the point. Brutus the Barber, Beefcake. Earlier on, I talked to the reigning Intercontinental Heavyweight Champ. The Honky Tonk Band have got these comments.
It's not right. It's not just right yet, Jimmy. It's not right for all of my friends and all of my fans. 7 days away, and you see I've got six on here. That means I've got six more days. I've got one each day to keep in tune, to get just right for you, Brutus the Barber. You think you're going to do some strutting? You think you're going to do some cutting? Oh, this is the one everybody wants to see. They want to see the Honky Tonk Man lose his ducktail. Is that what they really want? Or do they want to see the Honky Tonk Man lose something else? Do they want to see him lose the greatest Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship belt held by the greatest of all time?
The greatest of all
time? The greatest of all time. I think that's what they want to see. I say the people up in the executive offices of the WWE. Because you, Brutus the Barber, you didn't deserve this title shot. But 7 days from now, you're going to get the shot. You're going to get, boom, a blast from the past. Come on, Jimmy, let's go.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Intercontinental Champ Honky Tonk Man to defend against Brutus the Barber, Beefcake.
This bout is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, the individual managed by Bobby the Brain, Heenan. Weighing in at 275 pounds, Hercules. From Nashville, Tennessee, weighing 220 pounds, Reno Riggins.
Reno Riggins in there with Hercules. Bobby the Brain Heenan's Hercules. Of course, he is not here in the broadcast position at this particular point in time. Bell's gone and we're underway here. Hercules, very big matchup headed his way. Just 1 week away at WrestleMania 4, March 27th, Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino. going to be a happening. It's going to beat up and test the power and strength of the Ultimate Warrior. We've seen some of that in the past few weeks here in the World Wrestling Federation, but we saw at one point the Ultimate Warrior just snap that 15-foot steel chain of Hercules, and he didn't like it one bit. Oh, look at that one-arm power slam. This guy is a powerhouse. Nobody is denying that. And this is going to be just one of the tremendous matchups that's part of WrestleMania 4. I can't wait. Won't have long to wait now. We're just 1 week away from March 27th. 1 week away from the greatest wrestling extravaganza of all time. 1 week away of crowning the undisputed World Wrestling Federation champion. Right now, let's go to the Ultimate Warrior, who is going to meet this big guy, Hercules.
Hercules, you felt the power. You felt the power that makes the skies rumble and the earth shake. Hercules of WrestleMania 4. All you have to bring is anger and frustration. I live for anger and frustration. Combat is where we'll be. WrestleMania 4.
Well, you certainly don't have to get the Ultimate Warrior ready. He's ready all the time. Wow, youngster just went flying out of there. Reno Riggins getting a rude awakening here at the hands of Hercules. You know, I look at this WrestleMania as another holiday. This is like a Thanksgiving or a Christmas for me, because it's a chance for the entire family to get together and enjoy this special event. I look forward to it every year. Look at that. Whoa, what a clothesline by Herc. Just dropped it like a bad habit. Hercules does so many things well inside that ring, and since coming under the tutelage of the Brain, look out, here it comes. The horizontal backbreaker. Nobody gets out of this one. Be interesting to see, in fact, if the Ultimate Warrior can, should Herc be able to put it on him.
Here is your winner, Hercules.
All right, WrestleMania 4, 1 week away, ladies and gentlemen, get ready. All of the tickets are gone at Trump Plaza in Atlantic City. No home television. However, you can see the spectacular at home on a pay-per-view basis, or, of course, at a local closed-circuit venue near you. Strike Force, Rick Martel, and you, Tito Santana, your biggest title defense ever against Demolition.
Without a doubt, Mean Gene, and while Demolition and Mr. Fuji have been telling us what they're going to do to us, we have been getting ready for you, Demolition. Get ready for a hell of a fight, baby.
Rick Martel, you've got to share thoughts with us regarding this big one.
Yes, we're definitely impressed with Demolition and Fuji, but you know, we're not scared. We're not going to run away. The title's on the line, and WrestleMania 4, Strike Force will be there.
Away, Strike Force, to meet the Demolition. Speaking of Demolition, I spoke with them earlier.
Well, Strike Force, the time is getting very near, and we've done our talking. You look at Master Fuji's eyes, and when he's standing ringside, you really look close, because when he sits and smiles, Axe and Smash are going to tear your heads off.
1 week away, Axe, from potentially being the World Tag Team Champion.
That's right, Strike Force, 7 more days. 7 more nights of nightmares. 7 more mornings of waking up in a cold sweat. And you're right. You better show up in Trump Plaza, Atlantic City, because if you don't, Demolition, we're going to come to your house and beat you up. You know something? There's an old saying. This one's for you, Tito. This one's for you, Martel. There's no place to hide. Remember, boys, this is not going to be pretty. This is not going to be a wrestling match. This is going to be war.
This is a tag team bout scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring at a combined weight of 490 pounds from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, Mike Richards. His tag team partner from Columbia, South Carolina, Eric Cooper. Their opponents, making their way to the ring area, are accompanied by their manager, the Doctor of Style, Slick. At a combined weight of 705 pounds, from Kansas City, the natural Butch Reed. And his tag team partner from Chicago, Illinois, the One Man,
in WrestleMania 4 for the World Wrestling Federation Championship.
They're also looking at two guys that could be going against each other.
Well, they have been bracketed in such a way that it's possible. In fact, they could, in the semifinals, face each other. That would be something, right?
Who would you bet on?
I mean, if they bet each other?
Yeah.
I would bet on the gang, I would bet.
So would I.
We agree on something?
Boy, is Reno, is the gang in trouble.
Something's wrong here.
Well, you're finally seeing the light. That's what it's called, Monsoon. You know, like I was saying the other day, Vanna White and I were walking down Rodeo Drive. And a couple came up, they said, who is that on your arm? And I was going to say Vanna White. And they said, no, we're talking to him. We're talking to her. She said, that's the brain, Bobby Heenan.
I think your brain has been affected, Brain. You're worried so much about that six-man matchup. You know, that six-man matchup is indeed very important, but there are three titles at stake in WrestleMania 4.
The World's Tag Team Championship, Strike Force and Demolition. Yeah. Intercontinental Championship. Everybody thinks Honky Tonk.
Going to get a haircut and lose the belt.
To Brutus the Barber Beefcake? I don't think so.
Right now, folks, we're going to take you to the Slickster, who indeed will have a problem if both of his men do have to face each other.
Well, you know, I am the only one, you understand, with the Daily Double, and I will be the only one who will cash in. And as far as who will be the next WWE heavyweight champion of the world, well, it could be the gang or it could be the natural Butch Reed. Only I know. You gotta find out for yourself.
What a fountain of misinformation.
No, you're wrong. He's got it right. He's the only manager that stands a double chance. He's really got the odds on his side, but he could lose it all at once if they meet each other.
Well, absolutely. In order to be victorious, to make it all the way to the end, to be crowned the undisputed World Wrestling Federation champion, you must continue to be a winner in the tournament.
But I think Slick is enough of a gentleman to let those two fight it out. He'll go back to the dressing room, let those two fight it out, and may the best man win.
And that's not interfere whatsoever, right?
Well, who would interfere with?
What a dreamer you are.
He's a gentleman.
Oh, please.
So you think Honky Tonk's black hair going to be all over that map?
Wouldn't surprise me one bit, Brink.
You know, the winner of
Brudai tells me that he's bringing a big plastic bag as well. Stuff it all in there as a little remembrance.
That's for him to put over his head when he takes one of his girlfriends out. The way he's going to wind up looking. It's going to be a paper bag.
Right now, the natural doing a number on this youngster. Would you say, Brink, that is in fact Aaron Cooper in the ring, or is that Mike Richards?
It's not Gary Cooper, I know that.
Oh, that's for sure. Look at this.
That's Mike Richards. I got to do everything here. Uh-oh, 747.
There it comes. Oh, he buried him. Woo-hoo! Forget about it. He could just as easily do that to the natural at WrestleMania 4 as well. Let's get the official
word. Oh, my goodness.
The winners of this bout, the natural Butch Reed and the one-man gang.
Indeed, two big forces involved in WrestleMania 4. We're only a week away from these guys getting a shot, in fact, at the World Wrestling Federation Undisputed Championship. Right now, let's go back up the ringside.
Weighing 250 pounds, Tom Stone.
Tom Stone, a big challenge for him this week on Wrestling Challenge, if that's not too redundant for your brain. There's the ominous green bag, and we all know what it contains.
I never know what's in it. Could be five snakes in there. Well, that's a sick individual.
You never know with Jake the Snake Roberts. What a dynamic individual. Certainly glad that there was no ban put on the DDT. I'm sure you had something to do with that a while back as well. Did you not?
Well, I tried to help Jimmy Hart out.
I'm sure you did.
If he's smart, he'll eat Damien at home to watch WrestleMania.
What do you mean at home? If you didn't understand me correctly, Brain, there will be no home television of WrestleMania 4 unless, of course, you have the pay-per-view capability. However, closed circuit wise, it's going to be all over the place.
That's what I meant.
the snake can get another snake and go to some closed circuit market and watch it there.
That's...
I knew it was no TV at home. What do you think, I'm stupid?
Earlier on, we had a chance to speak with Jake the Snake Roberts with a golden opportunity for him coming up in just 1 week.
Damien, they tell me it's Rick Rude. The first round of the tournament, it's Rick Rude. Now, somebody told me that he's a real animal. Well, that's fine, because there's a difference between animals and serpents. An animal wants a bone to chew on. A serpent, we want it all.
Serpents want it all. Will it be a rude awakening for Jake the Snake Roberts, or will it be the DDT for Ravishing Rick?
Let's put it this way. Damien better eat all... the snake chow he can eat, because that man right there, Jake the Snake Roberts, is not going to be taking that bag home. If he's going anyplace, it's going to be to the...
You're upset.
I can't even think what...
You're upset, Brain.
Well, of course.
You got Matilda on your mind. You got Frankie on your mind.
Oh, I got snakes on my mind.
You got snakes on your mind. You got the Ultimate Warrior on your mind. Boy, you got your hands full. You got the King. He's got a big part, too.
Ravishing Rick Rude could be to come world. King. It's only a week away, and I can barely control myself.
Why don't you settle down before you have cardiac arrest? Oh, look out. Here comes.
No.
He pulled out of off. Give me a break. Stick the fork in Tom Stone. He's done.
The winner of this bout, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Jake the Snake Roberts, if he can do that four times on March 27th, 1 week from now in WrestleMania 4, he, in fact, will be the next undisputed World Wrestling Federation champion.
Never get, oh!
Oh, there it is!
Oh, my... Oh!
What will I have to do? Get some kind of a special belt for Damien as well?
Don't even... It's not going to go that far. He's never going to take that...
Oh, look at that!
Ladies and gentlemen, we are just 1 week away from the extravaganza in Atlantic City. 1 week from WrestleMania 4 at the Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino in Atlantic City, New Jersey. And please join me in welcoming my guests, the bodyguard Virgil, the million-dollar man Ted DiBiase, and of course the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant. Gentlemen, of course our focus, the championship elimination tournament. 14 top contenders here, two of them. For Ted DiBiase, your first round matchup to kick off the championship elimination tournament, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan, when you step in the ring with Ted DiBiase, the million-dollar man, you're stepping right out of your class. Not you, Duggan, or anybody else is going to stand in the way of destiny. That's right, destiny. And it is my destiny to be the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion. I said it a long time ago when I first came here that that belt, that gold championship belt, would be around my waist. And everything that I said that I would accomplish since I've been here, I've done. I've knocked them down one at a time. And I'm the only man that has ever accomplished the feat. In 4.5 years, Hulk Hogan, you held that championship. And for the first time in that length of time, you are no longer the champion. All those Hulkamorons out there, all those little kids that have looked up to you and idolized you all that time, they have no faith in you anymore, Hogan, because you're a loser. You're a beaten man. You're a defeated man. You're a frustrated man. And you are a loser, Hogan.
We can hear the chants, million-dollar man. Hogan, Hulk Hogan, for you.
Hello, Ken, you're in round two, Hulk Hogan. It's me against you again. But just remember one thing. I'm still undefeated. I'm the only wrestler still undefeated. But the people, they still call you. And after WrestleMania 4, they will still call you the ex-champion, because you're not going to make it to the round 4, Hulk Hogan. I will still be the ex-champion. Remember that.
All right, hi again, folks. Mean Gene Okerlund in the Sports Control Center, 1 week away from WrestleMania 4. At Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino in Atlantic City. Sorry to say, all of the tickets are gone in Atlantic City, but good news, you will be able to see it on a giant screen at a closed-circuit location near you, or, of course, on a pay-per-view basis. WrestleMania 4, all of the excitement, the glitter, the glamour, and big news, Gladys Knight and the Pips. Oh, they're going to be kicking it all off with America the Beautiful at WrestleMania 4. Some of their great hits, many of my favorites, Heard It Through the Grapevine, Midnight Train to Georgia, Neither One of Us, On and On, Gladys Knight of the Pips, and America the Beautiful kicking off WrestleMania 4. In addition, that spectacular elimination tournament to establish the undisputed World Wrestling Federation's heavyweight champion. I must tell you, ladies and gentlemen, 14 of the top contenders in the World Wrestling Federation are going to be vying for the gold. In the first bracket, a very interesting matchup. We find Hacksaw Jim Duggan going against the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase. And as of late, DiBiase has been the focus of a lot of controversy in the World Wrestling Federation, as you very well know. But I must say, as Hacksaw Jim Duggan looks to this elimination tournament 1 week away, he is very optimistic.
Oh, a lot of folks are looking beyond their first match, but not Hacksaw Jim Duggan. One focus, one thing in mind. DiBiase! DiBiase! DiBiase!
All right, in the very same bracket of this gigantic elimination tournament 1 week away in WrestleMania 4, Don Morocco is going to be facing Canadian strongman Dino Bravo. But The Rock is up and ready for this one.
Dino Bravo, you thought bench pressing 712 pounds was the test of your lifetime. Well, come WrestleMania 4. You got a new test, a new mountain, a new challenge to climb.
Here's another very interesting bracket in round number one of the elimination tournament a week away in Atlantic City in WrestleMania 4. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat meets Greg the Hammer Valentine, who has a revitalized career, he says, thanks to Jimmy Hart.
The Hammer is ready, Steamboat!
Steamboat, I'm gonna take the steam out of your boat, and I'm gonna sink your boat with the Hammer, and it's on to the World Championship in WrestleMania 4!
Ironically enough, the winner of the Valentine Steamboat match is really gonna have their work cut out for them, because in their bracket, the other two men to meet head-to-head will be the natural Butch Reed and Macho Man Randy Savage. Couple of things I like about the Macho Man. Number one, his phenomenal talent. And number two, his phenomenal manager, Elizabeth.
Freaked out. Ooh, yeah, 1 week away. Yeah, let it be known, the World Wrestling Federation top prize. Elizabeth, am I ready or am I ready?
You're ready.
I'm ready, yeah, natural, yeah.
All right, and concluding the competition in round number one of the tournament, the elimination tournament in WrestleMania 4, Ravishing Rick Rude will be going against Jake the Snake Roberts. What a tremendous card that involves all 14 of the number one contenders in the World Wrestling Federation today. By the way, in round number two, kicking that off, the match they've been talking about for a long, long time, of course, it's going to be Hulk Hogan, the phenomenal Hulk Hogan, going against the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant. This elimination tournament certainly worth the price of admission alone for WrestleMania 4. Also, I do want to remind you, all of the tickets are gone in Atlantic City. However, you can see it at a closed-circuit venue near you or on a pay-per-view basis in the comfort of your home. Many people, I've heard, are going to be throwing WrestleMania 4 parties in their living room. Be a little tough to clean up after, but I kind of like it anyway. The celebrities are going to be out. Mr. Baseball, Bob Uecker, is going to be back as guest ring announcer. Strange, I played third base for Bob Uecker one time. It was in a blackjack game at Trump Plaza in Atlantic City, if you know what I mean. A little levity there. I thought I'd throw that in. I probably should have thrown it out. By the way, speaking of celebrities, the presenter of the World Championship belt will be the host of the Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous, Robin Leach. We had to get comments from this gentleman.
I'm Robin Leach, and on March 27, join us for WrestleMania 4, when we'll bring you ring styles of the rich and famous, like Ted DiBiase, the Million Dollar Man, and Hulk Hogan. Remember, the whole world will be watching.
My attentions are going to be focused on Wheel of Fortune's Vanna White. She's going to be the guest timekeeper next week in WrestleMania 4. Intercontinental title defense, the Honky Tonk Man, to defend against Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Six-man tag, the British Bulldogs, Coco Beware. By the way, Matilda will be back next Sunday afternoon, the 27th, they're going to be facing the Islanders and their manager partner, Bobby the Brain Heenan. Strikeforce World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champs to defend against the Demolition. Strongman, Ultimate Warrior, and Hercules collide. An invitational battle royal with 20 of the greatest in the World Wrestling Federation. Remember, no home TV, only closed circuit, and on a pay-per-view basis, don't miss WrestleMania 4. I'm Gene Okerlund.
Next week, WrestleMania 4. Gotta see it. Closed circuit. Can't wait. Can't wait.
Next week, WrestleMania 4, closed circuit.
I'll be there. Will you?
You be there.
I'll be there.
You be there.
Yeah.
Well, if you are, in fact, planning to see WrestleMania 4 via closed circuit location as a public service this coming Friday, Brain, all your friends, check out the USA Today newspaper. It will list all the closed circuit locations for WrestleMania 4 throughout the entire country.
This bout is scheduled for 1-1. Soon to be making his way to the ring area, accompanied by his manager,
I certainly hope, Brain, that Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino has reinforced the ring, because in the first round of the elimination tournament, Bam Bam beats the Gang.
Well, I'll tell you something.
Well, tell me something.
Well, I'm trying to. Everybody's waving at me. They want my autograph. I'm going to get to it in a minute.
Oh, I think Bam White's got you all bent out of shape.
Bam Bam Bigelow will never make it past a one-man game.
You don't think so?
Now, Humperdink's got a real loser on his hands there.
You think so? Well, could be in for a very big shock, you know, because if Ravishing Rick gets by the first round, he, in fact, would meet Bam Bam in the next round.
Piece of cake.
Let's go to Ravishing Rick.
After I slither past you in the first round, Jake the Snake, it's on to the big boys. Bam Bam Bigelow, one-man gang. It doesn't matter which one. The new champion will be the sexiest man alive.
Well, Ravishing Rick looking by Jake the Snake Roberts with his sights set on Bam Bam Bigelow. That in itself could be a mistake, Brain.
Well, you know, you shouldn't do that. You shouldn't look, you should take one at a time. And I've told him that. But he's such an athlete, and he's so ready. He wants that world championship. I don't see where anything can stop him.
Well, that, in fact, may be true, right? That all remains to be seen, and it won't take long because we're only 1 week away.
Oh, am I ready?
Oh, we got the three count from Bam Bam, and we just learned as part of our WrestleMania 4 report that, in fact, in addition, celebrities, Gladys Knight and the Pips, they're going to do America the Beauty.
I knew that.
I knew
the winner of this bout, Bam Bam Bigelow.
Bam Bam Bigelow chalking up another victory with that cartwheel right there. This guy is ready. Look at this. Avalanche in the corner. Terry Gibbs just completely out of it. Here he comes off the rope. That could be the Gang down there. That could be Ravishing Rick. That could be a whole host of folks. Right now, let's go to a special interview with a former champion, the Hulkster.
All right, forget just around the corner, folks. This one is right on the block, 1 week away. Sunday afternoon, March 27th, Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino. And yes, WrestleMania 4 is nearly upon us. The great matches, Intercontinental title on the line, tag team title, the big battle, royal celebrities, the fanfare of WrestleMania 4, and of course the championship elimination tournament. 14 contenders, including this man, of course, Hulk Hogan, looking mighty impressive 1 week away from his chance
to become the undisputed World Wrestling Federation champion, fans have come up to me, Hulk, talking about the changes in your behavior, the almost maniacal behavior.
Well, you know, brother, it's not maniacal behavior, man. It's the behavior becoming a maniac, a star-craving Hulkamaniac, yeah, brother. Oh, yeah, all the little Hulksters on the left, all the little Hulksters on the right, man, we've trained and said our prayers and eaten our vitamins for 4.5 long years. But Ted DiBiase, brother, as far as I'm concerned, you, Bobby the Weasel Heenan, the Giant Virgil, when you started passing the cash around, you sold the rule book out too, brother. That's why the little Hulksters and myself have turned into stark raving maniacs.
Now, the tournament, of course, for you starts off with Andre the Giant. That's just the first match. You got to win 3 to win the tournament.
Well, you know, this isn't any fairy tale, man. Andre the Giant, Bobby Heenan sold you simply because he knew you could never beat me, brother. There's no beanstalk to climb to run and hide from Hulkamania. You're going to have to face me one-on-one. And once those big wheels of Hulkamania start grinding you up, brother, after I slam you on the East Coast and create a fault line all up and down New Jersey, everybody after you that's in my way on the way to that belt is going to be an aftershock, brother. What you going to do, WrestleMania 4, when Hulkamania runs wild on you?
Well, folks, that wraps it up for another week here on Wrestling Challenge, and another week brings us that much closer to WrestleMania 4. Next week, a blockbuster of a lineup. We'll be taking a look at the reigning World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Tito Santana, Rick Martel, Strikeforce.
They only got one more week, and that's it.
Also joining us next week, the policeman of the World Wrestling Federation, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Terminal idiot.
Friend of yours, right?
Yeah.
And, of course, our special WrestleMania 4 report.
Wow.
It's going to be a happening. Rick,
I can handle this.
Go ahead.
My man, and probably the next crowned heavyweight champion of the world, Ravishing Rick Rude.
That remains to be seen. And also a special live interview with a former champion, the Hulkster himself, Hulk Hogan. So until next week, Gorilla Monsoon for Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Yeah, I can say goodbye to him.
Go ahead. So long, everyone.
I'm not going to say it.